Jean-Pierre Deschelot, professor of nutrition at Rouen University Hospital in Normandy, France. I'm heading a clinical nutrition unit in the hospital and also a research group which is active in the field of nutrition and the gastrointestinal tract. In the last years, there have been increasing evidence that the gut-brain axis is important for the regulation of many functions and behaviors. What is the gut-brain axis? It is traditionally thought to associate the brain, of course, and the gastrointestinal tract with the neurohormonal connections between both. Now, the notion of gut-brain axis has been extended to include the microbiota, that is, gut flora within our intestine. And all these collaborate in the regulation of many functions. Among these functions, we have, of course, secretory and digestive processes, but also motor function of the GI tract and sensitivity of the GI tract to various stimuli coming from the food or from infectious agents. And finally, we have now new data suggesting that either the microbiota or the intestine by itself, by the delivering of specific proteins or specific peptides and neurosignaling, could influence eating behavior and also anxiety and depression. This is a fascinating new field of research which opens new possibilities for therapy of disease such as irritable bowel syndrome, eating disorder, obesity, and also maybe some other so-called psychiatric disorders that could be just a part of a derangement of a more global process. In this regard, the stress is really a major triggering event, and we know now that stress, even physical or psychological stress, is able to strongly influence our neuronal network and reactions, and also to trigger many hormones and mediators that will interact between the brain, the gut, and the microbiota to try to cope with this stress. And in the case this coping is not attained, then problems may occur. These kind of mechanisms have been described in the case of obesity, for instance, with disruption of the gut barrier by bacterial lipopolysaccharides, some pieces of endotoxin that can circulate and induce inflammation and also modification of adipose tissue metabolism and finally weight gain. It could be also the same kind of mechanism involved in eating disorder. In this case, it would not be LPS, but rather small peptides coming either from the bacteria or from similar structure from endogenous protein that could circulate and trigger the modification of endogenously produced immunoglobulins. And this dialogue between peptides and immunoglobulins could have different effects on the brain and specifically on the hypothalamus according to the level and to the affinity of these immunoglobulins. There are also very exciting new data regarding the influence of gut microbiome and inflammation on anxiety and depression. This will open new fields for clinical nutrition. Thank you.